Hello everyone, my name is Mandy Lynn. I'm the author of the fantasy novels Essence and I Am Mercy and soon to be published thriller novel She's Not Here. And today I'm going to be talking about how to work with beta readers to improve your novel. So last week I talked about how to find and choose your beta readers, so if you would like to watch that, it'll be linked down below and up in the cart. But this week I'm going to be talking about how to work with the beta readers that you've chosen. So my first tip is to decide whether you want to send your beta readers the manuscript as a whole or in bits. So I've seen people do it both ways. I personally just give my beta readers the whole manuscript and then a set of questions to answer after they've finished reading it. But then I also know other people send it in chunks, and after each chunk they have sets of questions that need to be answered by the beta readers. Tip number two kind of works off the first tip, but it's to give instructions to your beta readers. Tell them what types of things they should be looking out for. Should they be paying attention to the pace of the novel, the tense of the novel, the voice of the actual writing, different things like that. The more guidance you give your beta readers, the better results you'll get from them. Tip number three, I feel, is actually a very important tip, and it's to give your beta readers a deadline that is sooner than the actual due date you need it. This tip is super important because if you don't give your beta readers a deadline, they may or may not get back to you. But the thing with deadlines is that people tend to miss them. So if you give them a deadline that is sooner than you actually need it, then when they miss it, you'll be like, hey, that's okay, I'll give you another week and you'll be fine. So that's what I did, and it actually worked out very well because only one beta reader got back to me on time, but that is a-okay. Tip number four is to check in with your beta readers periodically. So this is important, especially if you give your beta readers a deadline that's kind of far away, because they may forget about the fact that they're supposed to be beta reading this novel. So if you just check in every now and then, say like, hey, I hope you guys are enjoying it so far. Just a reminder that you only have a few weeks left to finish it. And if you come back with feedback sooner, feel free to send it to me as soon as you have it. So this is just a friendly way to be like, hey, I appreciate what you're doing, but just make sure you're staying on track. Tip number five is to organize the feedback. So this is gonna be the most annoying and tedious process. It's really annoying to go through beta feedback one by one by one. If you kind of look at each one and then compare and contrast everyone's feedback with each other's, you'll kind of realize if there's patterns, if there's things you should be listening to, or things that you should be annoying that was, like, say one person was bothered by this one scene, but everyone else was like, hey, I love this scene, then you're not gonna have to worry about that scene. Next, learn to take the criticism. There's gonna be a lot of notes in your manuscript, and some of them you may not agree with, and some of them you may agree with, but you're just really annoyed by the fact that you have to fix it. As an author, you're gonna receive a lot of criticism, and especially so after you've published the novel. And after you've published the novel, you don't have the chance to fix things. So you need to take in the criticism before it's published, make those changes, that way it's better fit for everyone when it is published. My next tip is to know that you don't have to make everyone's changes. Just know that as beta readers are critiquing the novel, they're critiquing it to form the perfect version of that book in their own mind. Just because it's perfect to that one beta reader doesn't mean it will be perfect to the masses. So know when you're taking in criticism that you need to take it with a grain of salt, and when it comes to actually making changes, go with your gut to decide whether or not this beta reader is correct in their critique or not. My last tip is by no means necessary, but it's something I like to do. I like to give my beta readers signed paperback copies of the novel when it's actually published as a thank you. Beta reading is time consuming and it's by no means necessary, so I like to gift them this signed copy of the book for helping me create this published version of this novel. I do not tell my beta readers that they are receiving a signed copy when they sign up because I don't want that to be an incentive. I just want it to be a thank you gift as a surprise later on. That's it for today's video. If you have any other tips on how to implement beta reader feedback, leave them in the comments down below. Otherwise, that is it. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up, comment down below, and subscribe. Thank you for watching.